Hey everyone, Spazzy Dragon here, and today we're not gonna play Discovery Freelancer because the server is shitting itself. Like usual. Anyway, for those of you who don't know, the Discovery servers, not just the official one, but pretty much everything else, are under attack. So that is why you are lagging so horribly and why the server is constantly coming up or down. Currently, I have no idea what they're doing to fix this, but they are working on it. It's not just the Discovery Freelancer servers which are, contributing to fix this whole mess. So my own personal suggestion to you as a player is to calm down for a bit, let the server get fixed, and, don't annoy yourself by playing the game right now. The server is very empty right now, obviously, because it keeps crashing and restarting, just lagging all over the place, so if you ask me, this is the best time to actually try a different game, and today I'm going to bring to you zAngband. Now, if you've sipped through my older videos, you probably see that I already had uploaded a video about this particular game. And the reason why I tend to replay it once in a while is, let's just say today I have my nostalgia goggles on, because this is actually the first PC game I ever played. Well, that's not saying anything, because my first PC that I got my hands on to was, what, in 2003, maybe? So, you know, I'm not that old of a PC gamer. I did have an NES, I did have a Sega Genesis afterwards, but a PC was something a bit of a, you know, very far away, so to speak. Anyway, so I will provide the download link below and also link you to their homepage, because you will probably need to look at the tutorial, because in this video I'm not really going to focus on that. Anyway, have a look here. It's only 1.46 megabytes large, and this is one of those games that I really love to keep on my netbook, because it's so shit that I can't even run Discovery on it, and it just keeps me company, so to speak. Anyway, the way you install this thing is just drag and drop the whole zAngband folder on the desktop. As you can see, it's right here for me. And let's just quickly see what the game is all about. So this is how the game actually looks like. A window here, a window there. So yeah, welcome to zAngband. Not what you expect, didn't it? So the idea here, this is a roguelike game. If you don't know what a roguelike game is, then it's pretty much the same. Is Frap still running, I wonder? I have no idea. Moment.
Hello.
Alright, so Fraps was indeed running. Usually it shows me the FPS counter up here, but in this case it doesn't for some reason, so anyway. Let's just fix this. Okay, so zAngband. For those of you who don't know, zAngband, as I already said, is a rogue-like dungeon crawler sort of thing, and if you don't know what a dungeon crawler is, then you could technically say that all of the Diablo games are sort of dungeon crawlers, that Skyrim is sort of a dungeon crawler, because it involves dungeons, getting gear, leveling up. It's an RPG. And this might be a very old game, but the last time this was uploaded and updated was about in 2004, so it's not really that old. And this thing has, as I already said, this thing has a lot of nostalgia for me. Because, seriously, if you give this game a chance and ignore the fact that it's, you know, it sort of lacks in the whole graphics department, then you're gonna have a very fun time, because this game does things that modern games don't do these days anymore, and that is providing a pretty damn decent amount of challenge for what it does. So, first of all, let's make a character. Technically, this game is pretty much based on the D&D system, with a lot of other stuff mixed into it. So, if you've played D&D, or at least you know the concept of D&D, or you have played other games that use this sort of system, then you will instantly know what is what. We're gonna start off with picking the gender of our character, and we're obviously gonna go female, because, you know, this is a role-playing game. I am a male, so I must play a female. As you can see, now we have all these you know, all of these species which we can use. We have Amberite, we have Barbarian, which is for some reason a species, not a class. We had a Beastman, a Cyclops, a Dark Elf, a Draconian, a Dwarf, an Elf, Ghoul, Gnome, Golem, the list goes on, and humans, everything. Now, obviously, as I sit through these, you can already see that this is the sort of a description of the general stats, the strength, intelligence, wisdom, dexterity, constitution, charisma, and the size of the character, as well as how fast this thing gains experience. And infravision is something unrelated to that. As you can see, human is the base character, which everything else here is compared to. So, for example, a human has everything is 0, hit die is 10, and experience is 100%. This is the fastest character you can level up. An imp, for example, on the other hand, is going to have less strength, less intelligence and wisdom, more dexterity, more constitution, and it's going to be uglier. At the same time, it's going to be as large as a human, it's going to gain experience just a little slower, and it's going to have infravision that allows it to see warm-blooded species from afar. For example, a kobold is going to be smaller than a human, while a half-troll is going to be larger than a human's. Its hit die is going to be bigger. Anyway, that is the short version. I already said that I'm not going to go too much into detail on how the game works, so yeah. First tip, if you're gonna play this game, you will need to print out your controls, because every single key in this game is, in fact, used. Every single keyboard key that is available to you is used, and I highly suggest you play this sort of thing on a keyboard which does have a numpad key on its right, because if you want to use things like crossbows and arrows and slings and shit, you will need those keys. Anyway. We're gonna take a thing called a Beastman today, because the Beastman has a very interesting thing. If you don't know what a Beastman is, you can pretty much think of as a werewolf, as a worgen from World of Warcraft, pretty much a chimera. Now, as you can see, it's a bit larger than a human, a bit easier to hit. It gains almost 40% slower. It progresses about 40% slower. It has a bigger strength, less intelligence, wisdoms, and dexterities, and it's a bit tougher, but it's ugly as sin. And obviously we're gonna take this. The reason we're gonna take this is the fact that the Beastman as a class, species, is prone to a thing called mutations. Now, mutations are an interesting thing. When you level up, you have a chance to gain a mutation. I think it's 1 in 10. And the thing is that this is a completely random mutation, and when it comes to zAngband, random can be your worst enemy and your best friend. So let's just take it, it's gonna be more interesting. Now we can take a class. As you can see, anything that is in the parentheses is actually not advised. For example, a Beastman has very bad intellect and wisdom, so playing as a ranger would be a bad idea, or a paladin, because, you know, Beastman paladin, I want to see that. But no, today we're going to take something different. We're going to take a chaos warrior. This means that this is a servant to one of the chaos gods, and it just adds a whole level of complete randomness and fun in the game. So let's just take this one. Now we come to the auto roller screen. We have strength and we need to pretty much distribute. We need to put emphasis on things we want and don't put emphasis on things we don't. Now we are a chaos warrior, so obviously strength is going to have a level of 100 when it comes to rolls. So basically, if I set this to 100 and everything else on 0. Then anything that the auto roller is going to favor this stat. So, as a warrior, we will need strength, but as a chaos warrior, we have access to some sort of abilities and powers and magical stuff, so intelligence is still needed. Wisdom, not so much. We don't really need wisdom, although it should help us against other magical attacks, which, by the way, in zAngband are very powerful and, quite frankly, there is no reason for you not to use any sort of magic apart from outside of just, you know, because I don't want to or something. Anyway, dexterity, we are a warrior, we need dexterity, but again, constitution obviously, charisma, not really. Now it's going to roll about 500 characters and pick the best one. We have a skill, plus 3, which is cool, a percentage of deadliness higher than average, bonus to AC because of our size or something else. But just to be sure, let's re-roll this, and we can switch between these two last rolled characters. So which one is better? Obviously this one, because the saving throw is better than poor. Now obviously this is the starting character, so you know, it's a noob and everything is going to be pretty shit anyway. There we go. Drinking some beer while we at it. So let's name the character. It's a female Beastman Chaos Warrior. It's called Tina. Because why not? I love how they give a chance to commit suicide right at the character creating scenes. Like, oh god, I'm ugly. Control X. Okay, so yeah. Welcome to zAngband. If this is the first time you run the game, then it's probably going to be... It's probably going to be something like this. But you can change the graphics through here. I'm using old titles. If you want something a bit more fancy, you might use this. But I found this to be a little bit on the confusing side. I like this one. It's sort of a cartoony, bright, happy sort of thing. And yeah, as you can see, we have started off in a sort of a town. Now obviously this is a top view, right? We're looking down at the character. And I forgot the first thing that happens when you create a Beastman, you regain a random mutation. So this is the chat log, which is going to be above here, but... You feel different. You mutate. Your brain evolves into a living computer. So I think I just had my intelligence just grew up to the same as my strength. Which is a very good thing, because I am in fact a spellcaster and I need intelligence to, you know, determine the power of my spells. So that's always a good thing. Anyway, you move around with the arrow keys, and as you can see, every time I make a move, some other NPC does as well. So basically, this game is always paused, so you can, you know, run it in the background. There's no need to worry about anything happening if you're not, you know, tapped in on the game. So, you know, it's fun. This is the sort of thing I usually run in the background while I work, and this is very sane. Okay. So obviously, we're going to go on adventure! And something I forgot to actually tell you in the previous video, which I meant 1.5 years ago, was that this game actually does have some sort of final goal. I know, right? I didn't even know, because I never played this game through, because this is a very, very hard game. Okay, so technically, it happens like this. This little thing, that's a dungeon. You go down, dungeon crawl, get better gear, level up, etc. Fight monsters, die horribly. We know the drill. We have played games like this before. This is the level. Level 1 is the surface. As you go into that, it's going to be level minus 1, right? Because 0 is the actual, you know, ground. Okay, that doesn't make sense. As you go further and further, the goal of the game is to get to level 100, like depth level. We're going to call this depth level and character level, okay? You need to go to depth level minus 100 and defeat the final boss. It's completely up to you how to do that. And we're going to go into that a bit in a bit more detail afterwards, but you know, if I'm going to keep talking to myself like this, we're not going to actually play the game. This is the inventory. I just pressed I, and this is the inventory. We start with a Chaos Spellbook, a Sign of Chaos, which from which we will learn all of our stuff. as a spellcaster. We have 4 rations of food, we have 4 torches, which have each 3,500 turns of light. Every time I move, it is taking a turn, and this is going to be our light source for 3,500 turns of light each. Then we have a metal scale mail armor, which is always nice, and a broadsword, because, you know, we want to have a sharp pointy thing to shoot people with, hit people with. One of the things I didn't learn from the start is the fact that only because these things are in your inventory doesn't mean you're actually using them. So the first thing we're gonna do is press escape, so we close this thing. Press W to wield which item. And we're gonna wield the metal scale mail. You are wearing a metal scale mail. -2, which is the modifier for my dexterity, because, you know, it's heavy as hell, so obviously it's going to, you know, cumbersome me a little bit. This is the bonus to the AC class. My AC class determines how easy I am to hit and how much damage I can take, as in how much damage is reduced by this thing. And the +0 is the upgrade sort of thing. I'll get to that eventually. And we also want to wear a broadsword. So you are now wielding a broadsword. As you can see, we have plenty of things to wear. We have a thing for shooting. Stuff we can put on our fingers, around my neck. A light source, which is going to be our stuff, you know, our torch in a moment. We have a cloak. Which we don't have. Like, we will have a cloak, we will have some sort of gauntlets on, we will have a helmet, you know, all that sort of thing. Anyway, so what happens now? We start off with 100 gold coins, which we will need to spend wisely. And since we're going to go down there, I think the first thing we... Oh, this guy's coming for me. Is he? Is he? Yeah, he is. Okay, what do you want? I'm pressing S right now. I'm standing still, like I'm not moving. What does this guy want? The hobo drools on you. Okay, how about I slap you in the face then? You hit the hobo! You have slain the hobo. And apparently I didn't get any experience from this. Oh well. So this is the town, and these are shops. Let's go into this one. Warrior Hall. It sells armor and cloaks and gloves and some sort of very small weapons. Each of which has a price, and as you can see, the price is actually pretty high, and that is only because my charisma is pretty shit, so obviously they're going to ask more. This up here is a temple. This sells potions and scrolls. Oh, a ring of levitation. This actually is a pretty good thing. This, let's just examine B. You have full knowledge of this item. It allows you to levitate. Oh, I couldn't guess. I did not know that. Anyway, this place does not sell the thing I want. So let's go into this one. This is the supply store. Oh, and there it is. There's the thing I want. The scroll of World of Recall. Ward of Recall. Oh, it's 25% off. Oh, this is good. Oh, wait. How much? Oh, that's a scroll of light. Oh, 72. Okay, so I only have enough money for one. Done. You have brought a scroll of Ward of Recall for 72 gold. As I will go deeper and deeper, I will have to use stairs to move around between levels. Like, if I go to downstairs, I will go down. If I want to go up, I want to go up. Let's just say that I'm full of all sorts of goodies from killed monsters, and I want to sell these things off. And I really want to quickly get up, so this is going to be the scroll I'm going to read. Scroll of Word of Recall. It's going to just teleport me, wink, back to the surface. Costs a lot, and we just wasted all of our stuff on it, but, you know, it's worth it. Okay, what else do we have here? Magic wares. We have rods and wands. Nature's boring as hell. we don't want. And this is the bazaar. This is actually pretty fun. You can buy all sorts of things from here, and you can sell pretty much everything, but the prices are jacked. Seriously. Anyway. Let's go down. We're gonna press shift and point. You enter a maze of down staircases. More. Alrighty then, so what do we have here? I just came down to level 1 of the dungeon, and let's just see what we have here. A white icky thing, which is a monster, and a small kobold, which is also a monster. Okay, let's just sneak up on this guy. Oh, it woke up. The white icky thing wakes up. I'm gonna smash his face in. You hit the white icky thing. You miss the white icky thing. The white icky thing flees in terror, so obviously this is... this is the health bar, which relates to the last monster I attacked. Mine is over here, and maximum HP, as I can see, I have 17. So this guy is running away from me. It touches you. What? It touches you. Something just touched me. Something invisible just touched me. And this thing's back. Okay, let's slash diagonally up. You hit the white icky thing. You have slain the white icky thing. Okay. Something touched me. And the kobold just woke up. And it's coming my way. I'm currently pressing S, as you can see. Boosh! I hit the small kobold. I slain the small kobold. Okay. I don't see jack shit. And that's because I'm not wearing a light source. Let's wear a light source. There we go. Yeah, I found 15 gold pieces worth of copper. Okay, that's good. Oh, more money. Hey, look, we're almost back up at 100. If we are going to find something more, I'm going to instantly go back up because I need some... This is a magma vein with treasure. That's good. We're going to tunnel right into it. Yeah, found something. 31 gold pieces of copper. I wonder how much did it take to actually... Oh, it only took me... Okay, so... 15 turns to actually dig into that thing, at which point I actually said, this level looks reasonably safe. That's good. Because we are level 1, we don't need anything too nasty. Hey, look at this. This is a torch. We will need a torch. And some iron spikes, which I will then be able to sell off. And this is just your average... sort of dungeon crawling thing, right? We know this. You're just moving around. Hey, there we go. Hello. Oh, that's a kobold next to me. You hit the small kobold. We have slain the small kobold. Thank you. Oh, thanks for the gold, faggot. Okay. We're on a dead end, so let's just stand there for a moment. Ah, there we go. You have found a secret door. If you run into a dead end, chances are there. Oh shit, that's a lot. Okay. That's just a canine skeleton. And that there is a... It touches you. What? Something just touched me. And I don't know why. Oh! There it is! What the fuck was it? You hit it. You have killed it. Alright. I have no idea. Fuck off, Skype. You are not wanted. Yes, I want to exit. Fuck off. Okay, so I don't know what the fuck it was, because I can't see invisible things. Oh. The new just woke up, and it's coming right at me. Boosh. Oh. The damn thing bit me for... Wow, it bit me for 5 damage. Ow. You missed the new, you hit the new, the mute bites you. 7! Shit! Oh wow, that was actually... close. I just rested a little bit. And that is a kobold. Fuck you. Fuck you. Oh, more gold. Okay, what else do we have here? Another torch, which we can sell off later on. A flask of oil, which is used in, what's the name again? You know, lanterns. Because lanterns are cool. Now, when I'm moving so fast, I'm actually running because it beats having to press the keys around all the time, okay? Come on, unlock the door. Welcome to level 2. You can learn... Oh, I just leveled up, so this is what happens if you level up as a Chaos Warrior. Welcome to level 2. You can learn one more spell more. The voice of Balan thunders. Balan is... when you pick a Chaos Warrior, you're basically a servant to some chaotic god. Chaotic deity, sorry. So, Balan apparently is the one that's... You know, their names are randomized. So, when this happens, when you level up, something will happen. Something, like your god may do something cool, your god may do something stupid, or just, you know, kill you off. So, let's see. The voice of Balan thunders. Thou needst a lesson in humility, mortal. You feel less powerful. That motherfucker. I think he just reduced my stats, didn't he? Yes, I think we had an intelligence of 19 and a strength of 19, now it's 17 and 18. I humbly accept my punishment, dear... Balan. Asshole. Okay, let's rest up. Oh, this is stupid. I hate this. Like, there's a... It's not completely random. It's basically how well do you do against monsters. Your patron, like your chaotic deity patron, is always watching you and judging you like hell. So this is what happens if you are performing badly. Then the guy is going to be like, "Wow, you suck. Here, suck some more." Okay, so I actually have a bit of gold now. I want to go back up and buy some gear, because right now my stats are even more shit, so fuck. Okay, so let's buy a cloak. Let's buy some leather gloves, which we're going to wear right now. See, my armor class is going up. There we go. What else? I can sell my iron spikes here. It's 54 of them, actually. So, I'm back to 260. What else can I sell off? I might sell all three of these off for 3 gold each, because I don't need that many torches anyway. Torches are pretty common, so... Okay. Paper armor. There we go. Hard leather caps. It's basically a helmet. So we're gonna buy that, and we are also going to buy this leather shield, because, you know, a shield is good. So we're gonna wear the shield, and we are going to wear the cap. Now, if we're gonna go to our inventory, no, sorry, equipment, we can see that all that we lack on our body is the feet. So. Let's go to the bazaar, maybe there's something on the bazaar. Hard leather boots for 43, why not? That seems reasonable. There we go, and we're going to wear these well. There we go! Now my maximum armor class is 24, just as much as my hit points, so that's neat. You don't usually get, you know, more armor class than you usually have hit points, but, you know, this feels good. Okay, so we spent our money a little bit. Time to go back. Hello, icky thing. Boosh! Get wrecked. So, obviously, all of these dungeons are randomly generated. So, no one dungeon is going to be alike. Oh, treasure! New tunnel. Come on, you found something. There we go. Wow, 20 gold pieces worth. Oh, hello. 15, 20, okay. We're slowly making money. We will need money. This is a dead end. I'm pressing S. Oh, there we go. Oh, wow. That was completely unrelated. The blubbering inky thing drools on you. Here, drool on my blade, asshole. Okay, there we go. Then he drops some iron spikes. Oh, I just remember we can actually learn some spells, so let's just learn a new spell. Study which book? A. Study which spell? Magic Missile, because Magic Missile is awesome. It is literally the smallest amount of magic you can use that has a sort of a area of effect damage, so if someone is standing next to someone else, then... Nope. Copper. Copper's always dead. So yeah, if they're standing too close to each other, then you can actually, you know, deal some massive damages. Okay, this is a very small map, actually. Oh. There we go, secret door. Up. You have killed it. Okay, some of these monsters are actually invisible. Which sort of sucks, because you don't see them if you enter a room. And they can be very nasty, like, in the deeper levels. They can be pretty nasty. Okay, so you remember at the start of the video I actually said that this game does a few things that modern games have, you know, pretty much fallen out of. And one of the things, apart from complete randomness, it's so random, like with the mutations and the god who sometimes punishes you, that it can pretty much fuck over your progress, regardless of how well you're doing, right? So it's a very hard game in the sense that, you know, not everything is completely up to you. Oh, hello. Well, gee. Okay, is there... Ah, there we go. Let's try to open this door. There we go. There's a lot of empty rooms here. I don't like this. Hey, monies. Another thing... Okay, this is like poison gas. We don't want to go there. So one of the other things that I really like about zAngband is the fact that it doesn't really have this thing called a difficulty meter. Like, it doesn't have a difficulty setting. In modern games, you either have a slider, like Skyrim, for example, or Oblivion or whatever. Other games might start off, like, you start a new game and it's going to give you a chance to, you know, either easy, medium, or difficult setting, right? zAngband doesn't have that. Like, you are your difficulty setting, because right now, for example, this is where we came in, right? As you can see, if you go to that to the right, it shows that you're going to go up. This thing shows that you're going to go down, so we can go into deeper levels, and obviously the monsters are going to be a bit more, you know, dangerous. The loot is going to get better, and so on and so on. So that's the idea. I'm level 2. And I could go down to level 100 if I wanted to. I would probably die horribly, right? But at the same time, the game does not restrict me. It means that I could, in theory, just go wherever I want. I would probably die horribly, but it doesn't, like, hold me against the hand and say that, hey, you're level 2 now, you can go down there. Let's go down there so you can hit those monsters. So, I'm level 2. I could go down there. I even have a scroll just for that. I can go back up whenever I want. But I really want to reach, say, level 5 right now. Because the only problem with the Chaos Warrior is the fact it's still a sort of a magic user, so it doesn't have enough hit points. So, I want to... Oh, hello, the kobold. Fuck you. So, I want to just, you know, stack up on hit points a little bit before I actually go down there. Two down there. The only hint that the game gives you is the fact that your level is pretty much... It indicates that, yeah, and technically you could go down to level... sorry, level 2. But, you know... better not. And here's one of the things. Watch this. This is how you save the game. You just go into File and Save. Saving game, done. Now, this wouldn't be a big deal, right? But where is the save located? It's located in your zAngband folder under the folder Save. So, this is Tina. I actually played a guy named Trump, which died horribly, so you can delete it. So, here's the thing. This is your save. There is no such thing as quick saves. every time you save a character, it's going to overwrite this file. If you die, it's going to instantly overwrite your file. It means your character will die permanently. This game is permadeath. It uses permadeath. The only way you can go around it, as I already said, was pretty much every time you want to autosave, so to speak, you simply make a copy. So what happens, imagine I'm currently playing, I will die. So every time, it's going to overwrite this file, the one that loads automatically when I select this character. So if it died and I entered the game again and chose this character, it would just show me the game over screen, like that your character died, you got this far, blah blah blah. At that point, I'm just going to delete this file and just rename this one and just carry on. Anyway, let's see. What the hell is that? I think that might be a broken bone. Yes, that is a broken bone. I don't need a broken bone. And those are just some more metal spikes, which are always nice. Oh yeah! Let's say I just closed the door. Imagine someone's following, and some of these monsters can actually open the door, right? So I can press J. You jam the door with a spike. So what happens now is that the only way I can open the door is by, you know, forcing myself. But yeah, pretty much like this. It's a good way to just... You have a very bad feeling. Okay, so when you're in the level a bit, depending on what sort of, like, what level of sense your character has, you have a sort of a prediction. For example, this level feels average, this level feels unaverage. You have a very bad feeling. It means that somewhere within this level, like, this is the map, I'm currently looking at the map, somewhere within this level, there is a monster that can probably kill me very easily, so... This is the only hint that you're ever gonna get from this game. Hello there, worm. You hit the white worm ass. You have slain the white worm ass. I hate the worms in the sense that... Oh, there's another one. Is that... And there's another one. And there's another one. Yeah, they multiply if... Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Fuck. I can't lose. Oh shit, that's a lot of them. And I'm poisoned. Fuck. This is bad. Okay, let's go away. My health is dropping. Okay, I'm not poisoned anymore. Anymore? So yeah, you need to be very careful about monsters that, you know, multiply like this because holy shit. Oh, hello. Because they can instantly fill the whole dungeon in, and they can box you in like this, and you can't get out, and this is why I'm actually carrying that scroll that allows me to sort of just teleport up to the surface. And that's the only reason why I'm actually spent all that starting money on it. I want to get this. Why can't I get this? I'm tunneling. Ah, there we go. 44 gold, not bad. Where's the secret door? There it is. Okay, this is a gray mold. I hate these things, and I'm gonna show you why. So, the gold misses. Okay. So the idea is that the mold is unable to move around. So right now I'm standing still, right? I'm pressing S. See? Nothing happening. The mold is physically unable to move, but the problem is that obviously, because it's not moving, it means that it has some sort of, you know, other way that it's, you know, pretty nasty. In our case, it has this stupid... The gray mold hits you, gray mold hits you. Well, apparently I was stronger than I suppose I was. So yeah, molds and jellies are... pretty damn stupid in that regard, that some of them damage your armor with acid, some of them confuse you, some of them leech off your experience points, some damage your stats, and that's the last thing you want, because restoring stats is very, you know, it costs a lot. Nope. Shall we go deeper? Yes, we will. Okay, level 3, and I am a level 2 character. How bad will this be? Actually, well, let's see. Experience 34, maximum experience 34. Experience, and we're close to our level up. Your light is growing faint, so we... So yeah, our torch only has 90 turns of light, so... We are going to press Shift and F to refuel, and we're going to combine one of our torches. There we go. And now it's back to 100, like 1500 again, so that's good. Okay, let's see. More gold. More gold is always good. Oh, we almost have 500 gold, so... The blinking dot. Some food. Oh, fuck you. Fuck you. Welcome to level 3. Oh, this is gonna be good. Welcome to level 3. You can learn one more spell. More. The voice of Balan booms out. Thy deed had earned thee worthy reward. More. You feel something roll beneath your feet. Pick up a small sword. 1d7. Okay, that's gonna be interesting. Pick up a death spellbook, Black Prayers. Well, I can't use death magic, so, you know, thanks, bullshit patron deity thing, but, you know. I'm more worried about the short sword, because anything that a chaotic demon drops for you is, you know, as a gift, it might be something holy shit awesome, or it might be something holy shit please get it off, I'm dying horribly. So, obviously, I'm not going to wear this, As time passes, if you pick up some sort of items, and as time passes, it's going to say that, oh, this thing feels average, or this thing feels cursed, or this feel, you know, some sort of something like that along those lines. Okay, this level looks reasonably safe. That's good, because I'm currently level 3. I'm level 3. This shouldn't be as bad anymore. Anyway, we can learn one more spell. Okay, Trap Door Destruction. Completely useless, quite frankly, but, again. We could go deeper, and we shall. And that there is a blue ooze. Let's try casting a spell. Let's open our spell book. Let's cast Magic Missile onto that blue ooze. Boosh! The blue ooze dies, and they drop something. And a silver wand. They drop a silver wand, which is always nice. Oh shit, you hit it, you have killed it. That's a kobold. The kobold flees in terror, okay. Where did it go? That was a large kobold, those things hurt actually. I don't want to run, because if you run, then they get the first hit on you. Padded armor, okay. I found some armor, which is, you know, a bit stupider than the one that I have right now, but... Oh! The kobold is running away. Let's see if he's somewhere in front of us. Magic missile, which I failed to get off. Shit. Oh, hello there! Boosh! Where'd it go? Come back! Ow! Fucker hit me. See, the fucker hit me for quite a bit, actually. Eight points. If I was a level, you know... If I was a slightly lower level, that would have been pretty bad. Okay, let's explore a little bit more. So I've been playing for 45 minutes, huh? Fair enough. Die. Oh, titanium wand. I like this. So obviously, before we use this wand, we have no idea what the hell it is. Oh, that's a worm. So let's just aim a wand. You fail to use the wand properly, okay. the blue worm mass starts moving faster. Shit. Haste monster. Just my luck. I don't want it to... Blue worm mass crawls on you. You are covered with frost. Shit. Close the door. Jam. There we go. Yeah, that was a bad place to go, and there's a lot of frost worms, and I don't like these. Okay, let's eat something before we die horribly. There we go. We just ate something, which is always good. Oh. Fuck. Let's go back, close this door, jam. Yep. Let's not go there! This is a room that is not lit when I enter it. There we go. Oh, kobold. Fuck off. I'm gonna magic missile you. It dies. You just drop more inspire. Okay, helpful. We are at 114% of capacity, which is bad. Means that we're gonna get slowed down if we continue this. I think we will need to drop the spikes somewhere. Yeah, we're gonna drop the spikes. L? 78 of them. And, K? Let's drop 30 of them. We need at least one spike. Oh, let's see. Okay, 91%. Good. Okay, this is good. Wolf, farmer, maggots, dog, bite you. Fuck off! Oh, it dies. Welcome to level 4! You can learn one more spell. Okay, what is our bullshit patron deity gonna do now? The voice of Balan booms out. My pets, destroy the arrogant mortal! Oh shit, it just summoned stuff around me. The old man Villo misses you. The old man Villo misses you. The radiation eye gazes at you. You feel very weak. Shit! Read. The air around you becomes charged. Oh my god, this is so bad. Magic missile. Shit. I'm not afraid of death. I just don't want to be there when it happens. Dump the screen. Fuck, I died! Ah, fuck. Hey, and when was the last time I saved? Fuck. Oh, well, thank you. I suppose I shouldn't have named it a bullshit deity then. Well, this is no problem, really. Okay, exit. So this is the character that is dead now. So I need to delete this and rename this back to the original. That's a lot of fraps material. Okay, let's launch it again. File open. Tina. Back to level 2. Fuck.